PC Expo, which will be held in Mirai Kan in Japan. So the first debut of the student's work at SIGGRAPH, so this is a student work. So in SIGGRAPH 2002, this virtual chamber was selected as ETEC. Although they are the university student, they presented this one, and this was accepted with lots of the glory. And after that, we have several teams coming here, selected by the emerging technologies of Japan. And these are only the example of the students' work selected for ETEC. So it's a long, long history. And we have the cooperation with the Laval Virtual. So someone who won the Laval Virtual prize at the virtual reality contest, they are invited to Laval Virtual. And also several works at the Laval Virtual will be selected for the final stage for the IVRC. So it's an all international cooperation program between the students. So it's a Laval Virtual. This will be presented after that by the Laval Virtual. So this is the agreement on the international cooperation, the Laval Virtual 2004. And we also had, right now it's not on the EU, but we have also had the international cooperation with ETC, CMU. So this is the partnership in SIGGRAPH 2010. So we have the kind of the history of the virtual reality. So I think we have the 25 or 30 year cycle of virtual reality moves. And after the virtual reality moves, 3D and virtual reality have been 30 years of cycle. And the first 3D, dawn of 3D was in 1920. And at that time, we have the mechanical shutter glasses and also several things happened. So it's a dawn of 3D. The first 3D was in 1950s, and at that time we have some words like the 3D craze, that kind of word, terminology was born. And in 1980, also the second virtual reality wave. And in 2010, we have the third 3D wave. After the 3D, we have the virtual reality. Roughly speaking, 10 years after 3D move. So if we see the 3D, we would like to see interactively. We see the 3D from several points of view, and we would also like to touch or manipulate the 3D objects. So that is the virtual reality. So that is why we have always have the virtual reality move or wave or phase after the 3D. So the first dawn of the virtual reality, as you know very well, it's Ivan Sutherland in the 1960s. And also Sensorama of the Heidi. And also in 1990, the first virtual reality. Virtual reality was born in 1989. So as we think, maybe 2020 will be the second virtual reality wave, and that kind of the things are happening right now. So in 1989, VPL, research data graph and the iPhone were invented. So then the term terminology of virtual reality was first presented here. And it's a long, we have lots of history and in 1993, we have the virtual reality contest. And we have the 24 years of the history of the virtual reality contest. More than 200 projects have been realized. 23 IVRCs, including 21st project, selected as single tech leader. Average 5 persons for each project, meaning over 1,000 persons, have deeply experienced and understood deeply virtual reality. IVRC students become staffs, and staffs now become world famous professors, designers, creators, and engineers. These are the few of the examples of the alumni members of the IVRC. So it's 25 years right now, so lots of persons who are young. Right now it's in the middle of the virtual reality of interactive technologies. So 21st century brand engineering challenges. This was the announced by the National Academy of Engineering in 2008. And they selected 14 challenges. One of the 14 challenges is virtual reality. So this comes true. And this is the dawn of the second kind of virtual reality wave. So you see lots of the virtual reality right now, as we had before in the late 1980s and early 1990s. So as I presented before, we have the second virtual reality wave, and some kind of the predecessors are right now you see lots of the some forerunners of that kind of things, like the very good HMDs and lots of the interaction devices. So we would like to see the virtual reality wave and interaction, and from the virtual reality contest, they will have the lots of people coming out also. So we would like to have the expand our international cooperation. And if you are interested in international cooperation, please come to us and we have some ideas. So we have some kind of cooperation, kind of sponsorship. So this is some kind of some of the sponsors we have right now, and they are growing also. So this is just a short history of the virtual reality and future of virtual reality contest. So thank you for your attention. Thank you very much.
Thanks to my friends, we have achieved some. Other time, HMD is very expensive and hard to make by ourselves. Instead of HMD, we have developed data blocks, a sort of data block, by using optical fibers. And by using data blocks, so we try to control home appliances by using gestures and gestures like this. Also, we have made some handmade eye tracking devices by using parallel computer processed computer vision. And finally, so Fenara's fourth year as an undergraduate course, so we have